Hello guys, my name is McCheese. I'm standing right. No, OC, I just had a perfect picture. Anyways.
What?
I am the guy standing on the ground.
Boss
and
on the tortoise.
Exactly, Osiris. Right there next to me on his giant two-faced turtle where he's sitting like a boss. And
without
now it's trying to eat
using
me, please.
My...
yeah,
my
lucky you. Right, so we are finally back here with a little more in-depth look at Rev, talk about some more of the features the game have, show you some more content from here. It's kind of been a long time coming, this video. We know we kind of ran out of time in the end, back in the end of June. We had a lot of plans and...
Summer vacation stuff and everything.
Yeah, exactly. I had exams I had to get done, and after that I had to prepare for my hiking tour in Norway, where I visited you, among other things. It was a couple
indeed.
Of awesome days.
Which, yes, was very awesome indeed. Just been busy besides that, really, and not been that active in gaming in general, personally, actually.
No.
I have not played a lot of games.
Same.
So
that's something we'll have to remedy. But yeah, we're back. So let's get to it. This
Woo-hoo.
Is...
We are playing Rift.
yeah.
What a beautiful game this is. Whoa, is that...
What?
Is that a crocodile?
Oh dear, they have so many awesome mounts in this game. Of course, they all left now. There was like a ton of awesome mounts just before. Stand still, crocodile, stand still.
Yes, if
oh dear, Jesus,
if
that looks...
If an employee watches this, please log into this game and see how a celestial mount it has to be made.
And, yeah. Yeah, they have a pretty awesome celestial
so
horse,
much
too.
Here.
I'm pretty... I think the guy
is
pretty
picky,
happy there's
yeah.
a saddle on that one. That looks rather unpleasant otherwise to be sitting
yeah.
on.
Looks pretty painful.
Right, so anyways, this is... Oh god, I already forgot the name. Like, Meridian or something, right?
Meridian,
right.
Yes.
The main city, capital city of the Defiance, if I'm not mistaken. Quite big it is. Oh well, it is. We have this courtyard out here where we have a lot of... trainers for the various classes, and we have profession trainers and stuff standing around. And besides that, we have this huge keep in the background, which you can actually... There
oh,
is
I'm
a,
sorry. Profession trainers?
What?
Oh yeah, you meant like that.
Yeah,
right?
I meant like crafting professions. No,
class.
I got my facts straight. Don't you even try that.
You're correct.
Yes, thank you.
I got trolled trying to troll you. That's that. Yeah.
Yeah, nice try. Right, but otherwise, that doesn't seem to be too much to see in the city. This is obviously where you get pretty much everything. But I won't give you an entire tour here because we have a lot of other stuff to do. Ozzy, are you following me? Seriously?
It is
yes, stupid.
It is quite a sizable city. It kind of reminds me a little bit of... Lol, look at when I walk backwards, how I hold the saddle. Like,
I was just
whoop,
checking
I'm
out the map,
enough.
Man. Yeah, because you
look.
Really have to look backwards. I'm more worried about the turtle. Though definitely got two heads, so... Oh, damn,
yeah, it reminds me a bit of that city in Lord of the Rings where
Minas Tirith, by any chance?
They have that last battle.
Yeah, probably.
Or not
Minas
the last
Tirith.
Battle.
But are we talking Minas
the
Tirith
one that
or not?
Is in the rock.
Yeah, Minas Tirith. God damn it, Ozzy. yeah, it
I don't
does
know my
it
Lord
does
Rings
somewhat
lore. I'm sorry.
Except I'm going to give it to Minas Tirith. That looked a little bit more awesome, to be honest. Cut out in of the mountain.
Oh yeah.
But
it's,
that's
it's a pretty
that.
Cool city, though, nonetheless.
Also, just...
mechanical mounts.
Yeah, so we're playing as the Defiance, mechanical and mounts. As I think you said in the last episode, although that is like a month ago, so I already forgot everything you said in that episode, we are the more science,
jeez,
sciencey guys. Well, I actually, Ozzy, just be glad I even listened
yes.
to you.
at all, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. But yeah, we got some very awesome looking mechanical mounts here. They look so cool. Even got a tail, which, I don't know, guess they really liked how horses look in real life, so. Right,
I just
but
signed up
anyway.
for a Warfront
Yeah, I
BP.
was thinking that. We got the Black Garden, and we got the Library of Rune Masters. We'll take the Black Garden. Let's do it. I don't think I
Dude,
can
I just
sign up
signed up
as a
as a group
UA.
for both, so.
Oh, good. So that's why it says
I
queue.
already
Jesus,
did.
I was like, what is this?
What is going on?
Yeah. Why is this game doing this?
Let's go to our questing area.
Yeah, definitely. I'm coming down the walls. Another guy here giving a red quest,
So,
I'm not sure that's
obviously.
him.
Oh, dude, there's a rift here. Let's go do a rift. This game's called Rift. Let's do a rift. That would only
Yeah,
make
that makes
sense.
sense. It makes sense.
I am sure you can handle this.
Where are you again? Oh, you're out there. Alright, cool. Let's go do it. So, yeah, Rift is kind of one of the
So, this
things that
game.
make this game stand out from previous MMOs, right? And
Yes.
you have been
It
playing it
basically has a
before, so.
traditional questing system with quest hubs, and you can't get through the whole game questing. But there will be rift spawns all over the world, which are just random rifts, and they're pretty basic, just like mob waves that you need to fight, and the last wave is usually like a boss. But the cool part is that there will be invasions, like just now. Oh no,
Oh,
never
see,
mind, this is
it's
rift.
level
There will be
17! God
invasions.
damn it! Wait, level 17! Hurts!
There will be world, or not world, world events, but also like area events, and you need to close down base within a certain amount of time, and it is pretty damn epic. Okay, never mind that rift.
There's another one over here, it looks like. Over here on the field, straight ahead.
It's high level because we are actually really close to the instance right now, so.
All right, let's try this one. But yeah, you were saying?
Let's go to our questing area because that is also pretty high.
Okay.
I was saying that there are some pretty cool events that pop up, like area events, where you get an objective saying you need to close down 50 rifts. Ooh, enter the map. Let's do that.
But carry on.
Yeah, and you just get like an objective to kill 50 rifts within a certain amount of time, otherwise you fail or otherwise you get overrun. And when you do that, the next step will come, and then you need to like bring certain things to certain NPCs and kill certain bosses, and it's really quite cool. They got quite challenging at the moment. Okay, this is
Oh,
interesting.
this is a game that's
What the fuck?
already in action or what?
What are we doing?
I don't know, man.
What's your
You're the one who's
objective?
been playing this game before. It seems like, do we have to go down like over
I've
here or
never
something?
played any PvP.
Killing spree.
I think so. Ooh, first
Okay.
blood.
Yeah, excellent. All right, so
Except I didn't do
let's go kill
anything.
some stuff.
Oh, you are victorious. That's
We! Yes, Ozzy! God damn, we kicked ass!
good job, man.
Yeah, man, that's how we roll.
Sweating like a mofo here. That was intense,
Yeah,
intense.
jeez. Oh, the PP in this game is just crazy.
Ooh, Jesus Christ.
Right,
All right,
let's just
let's sign up for that
resign
one
then.
again because that
Yeah.
seemed pretty interesting. The Black Garden is the one. Actually, let's read up on that. The Black War Garden is the one with the fang that I told you about. You pick it up, and you receive damage over time the longer you get it.
Yeah, cool.
And the team that controls the fang longest wins, which is pretty cool. Library
Then let's go for it.
of Rune Masters. You must fight to control these powerful vessels. Be warned: the longer one is within your grasp, the more its dark power will eat you away to your soul. Okay, that sounds
That sounds
pretty
pretty cool. Let's do it. And
reasonable.
let's get on these quest things. I am not quite sure where we were questing last time.
Just check the circles on the map, man. Who
Yeah,
needs
but
reading?
I'm actually not seeing the circles right now, which was.
You need to track them, man. You need to track them.
God damn it, all this
God.
tracking and stuff. Let's just kill stuff. You can lead the way.
You're too used to Guild Wars 2 lazy mode, not having to worry about anything, just walk around and kill stuff.
Never tracked yesterday. Okay, cool. Black Garden.
Ooh, there we go.
Let's do it.
Okay, so the queues are pretty good.
Yeah, that's just the
Low level, that's pretty
level
interesting.
10 to 19. These ones, that's actually very good.
So, this game is going to introduce the three faction PvP,
They
right?
have,
The
if you will,
next,
they were introduced
but they
in
have
1
already.
point, yeah, in 1.9.
Oh, right.
Um, which
Do I
which
die
were
when I touch
rolled
these
out during
statues
the
that
summer.
team?
So they have 3 faction PvP already called Conquest.
How is that received? Have you read anything about that?
No, that I have not.
Yes, I have not.
I actually just noticed it last night while I was preparing some notes that the 1.9 was released already.
I should look up some YouTube vids on that.
But that's pretty cool. I think I'm glad to see they have implemented it actually, because I think the 3 faction PvP system is a great way to go.
I'm pretty sure that eventually World of Warcraft will come with something like this as well.
I'm guessing it. I mean, they've just in Myst they've just introduced 2 new different PvP modes in Battlegrounds, and one of them is quite like this one, where you have to get an artifact and it'll be tougher to keep the artifact over time.
Yeah. But World of Warcraft is pretty good at staying ahead of the game, where they look at other games, what they're successful, and try to not necessarily steal their ideas. I mean, obviously, games
take. Well, they're making direct copies, but that's totally how the industry works, right? I'm going on the left-hand side, by the way.
It's stupid to not do that. I mean, if something is fun and it works, why not implement it?
Yeah, exactly. Well? If it fits into a game, then do it.
It fits
in
the universe, so.
Okay, yeah. I have no idea. What are we going for again here? This place out here?
We just kill people.
Yeah, that seems reasonable.
There's a fang somewhere.
Okay, they're like level... Ah, fuck, that's level 18 over there, but there's also a level...
I'm just gonna go for it, man. Go for it. Cleave. Finish.
What? I can't even... Damn, Ozzy.
And I'm dead. Are you healing?
I am not healing, because I don't seem to be... I have one healing spell, but I can't seem to use it.
You're pathetic.
Hey!
I'm just kidding. Alright.
I'm trying to get this guy down, but seriously, I'm not a ranged guy, which is kind of a problem.
What is your spec exactly?
Some cleric thing.
Yeah, no, I mean that's your class, I mean your spec.
Yeah,
your,
I know, but
your
it's
soul.
Not like
what
I...
What is your main spec?
God
damn.
Well, I'm dual spec currently down into 2 trees. Let me see. Currently, I'm mostly a Justicar. I'm actually down in all 3 trees, but I'm currently mostly a Justicar.
That means you're a melee guy.
Yeah, exactly. Which is probably at a disadvantage for me, given that I'm only level 11 right now.
Also, you can loot corpses.
Well, we're not here to loot corpses, we're here to kill stuff.
I like to loot corpses.
Okay,
loot,
where's the item we have to get?
It's on the... here. No, it's not here. I don't know where it is. I think the enemy has it.
I'm going down. I'm pretty sure I have something called an AE heal. Restores 86 to 90 health up onto 10 players, raid members. Removes 1 conviction. By the way, are we the blue team or the red team in this thing?
We are one of the 2 that you mentioned. I don't know.
Yeah, thanks.
I'm being one of 2
classes.
I'm not doing any damage, I feel.
Well, this is the constant problem, at least when you're a melee character like we are. That getting in and getting into the combat actually is pretty damn hard when you're underpowered. Though admittedly, I actually feel like I can do some kind of damage to the enemy, which is good.
At least people are not shouting here like in World of Warcraft, you fucking noob, blah blah blah. Or maybe we are just not.
Maybe, I don't know, I can't see any chat, so hopefully they aren't, but it's more likely that I just don't have the chat up or something. Damn it, and I died again.
Oh, there is the chat.
Yeah, but I don't see...
Warfare in chat, I just mute. Savior. I just mute.
Yeah, just don't draw any attention to yourself, man. They'll just notice how horrible we are.
I feel... I don't know if we were winning. I feel underpowered. Also, I'm lagging because my girlfriend is downing something, so that doesn't really help.
Seriously, Ozzy. That's just not cool, man.
I'm not dedicated.
No, you're not dedicated at all. And I'm going to play Guild Wars 2 with you? No way, dude.
I am dedicated.
Yes, I totally see what you did there.
Yes, isn't it awesome?
Hey, I just used my heal. Excellent.
Excellent.
Yes, very excellent.
Healing is pretty cool in this game, actually. You get some pretty cool healing abilities. Yeah, you have like 3 healing souls as that class.
Healing souls? Oh shit, that's how it works.
Soul,
I see.
It's like balance.
We should probably have taken like a test PvP round just to figure out stuff.
No. Test rounds.
Why would we? No, apparently that's not how it works.
Mr. Healer's just standing in the back of healing people.
Yeah, oh dear, are you surprised? I'm kinda low on mana right now, that's not very good.
Well, I just got 10%
so
of that.
To be honest, I don't think it's very cool that you can loot corpses in PvP, to be honest.
What's wrong with that?
Because people end up focusing on looting corpses, right? Instead of
looting.
Yeah, instead of fighting. I mean, I just did it, but then again, I'm just a slacker and I wear out of mana and low on HP.
I don't know. Maybe it's just. I think. What team are we? It'd be nice to know which team we are. I think we might just be blue.
I'm hoping we are. It would make sense to make, you know, your own team blue, and then the opposite side probably see the same thing.
Oh. The Fang is here, I'm gonna grab it.
Then grab it, man, and run away. Yes, good, Ozzy, good.
Achievement!
Run away, run
corruption.
Away! You can do it!
No. Oh,
alright, excellent
down.
Job, man. Now we are getting them. Where are they? What are they doing?
Seeing as we gain point is blue now. Oh no, it's red.
They're not even.
So I'm gonna die at some point, though.
Probably, but we are going to protect you. That's why we are here.
No, I drop it. Like that.
You dropped it?
Come on, drop it.
You're not supposed to drop it.
No, I can drop
it. You shouldn't. It's probably
yeah,
a bad idea
can,
to drop it.
I get damage over time.
Oh, I see. So you need somebody else to pick it up, or... Ah, damn it, dead again.
I don't know how to drop it, though.
It's not just like a buff you can click on?
I'm dead. No, it didn't work. I tried. Hey, I got us some points, man. I think we're the red team.
We're the red team? Oh, crap. If we're the red team, that's not good. Why? That wouldn't make any much sense, would it? I mean, is there any place where it's clear that we are the red team? Oh, there is. If you press on the button in the middle of the UI thing, you know? There's like a little button that shows the player screen.
Right.
That, there we can see we are the red
so
team.
We
that's,
are...
That's not intuitive, I'd say, but that might just be me.
Yeah.
I mean, I'd have expected that every team just saw their own color as blue. That would make sense too, right? It's not like
yeah.
The other team cares for what, you know, what we see. Oh. All right, so we lost this one, but we won the last one, so, you know.
Yeah, we did.
It all
seems
to add up quite nicely.
We put a lot more effort into the other one.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, we're just slacking this one, basically, so... Isn't really fair. Right, so let's get back to this stuff and see if we can find a rift or what.
I'm just foraging this herb.
Yeah, take your time. Now I'm totally not sure if we actually done talking about rifts and stuff. Oh, that's pretty decent actually.
Could you just either take it or leave it, because I want to skin the shit out of this thing.
Yeah, relax. My inventory is horribly crowded currently.
Not literally in any sense, because skinning the shit out of an animal would be kind of weird. Okay,
there goes. I totally forgot to see a vendor before we left. That's kind of stupid.
You were even talking about selling stuff before we started.
I were, and then I don't know what happened.
Let's go find a rift. I don't know. So there's two sides to this game. Three. One, you have instance PvP. Two, you have instance dungeons, which are 5-man dungeons, which you can do in normal mode and expert mode, which opens up an extra part of the dungeon with extra bosses, plus all the previous bosses
cool.
harder, and it's max level only. Then there's raiding content, which will be 10 man and 20 man raids, which are really quite challenging from what I've seen and heard. Then there are rifts, which you can just do with random people. You don't need to be grouped. You can just randomly join a group automatically, and it works very well. But then there's also stuff you can farm inside the instances, which allows you to open up 10 man raid rifts, which are a lot more challenging.
And
so
when you
a
open up
content.
Is that the 10 man raid rifts, are they like instance 2, or are they just open world where everybody can join in?
I can't remember. I think that it might be closed off, but I think it might also be open. I can't remember really. I remember being ganked on the PvP server, so it might have been open, but they said it was open for change, for that they could change it because they weren't sure how well this system would work, and they could always change it. So I don't know what it's right now.
It can be kind of, you know, difficult with. It's not fun if you've farmed for a long time to open up a rift and then you're getting ganked.
Oh no, that happened. We ganked level 50 on our PvP server, and then we farmed some instances and we went to do a rift and we got ganked massively and we just rerolled to a PvE server straight away.
Yeah, and just to be clear, level 50 is the current max level, right?
Yeah.
Though I'm pretty sure they're working on an expansion, if I'm not totally wrong on that, where the max level will be 60. The OC, there's another one right over here.
You are not
right.
Yeah, I'm just foraging.
Okay, that's cool. I'm done with that quest, by the way.
Any rifts this plus by? No.
What do we got over here? Oh, we have to go and investigate something over here. Are you soon done with all these quests?
I am soon done with all these quests, if I can click this stupid... What the fuck is going on?
What's going on, man?
I need to loot two more of those thingies.
Okay, I have stolen some from you then.
I'm not sure what I think about games implementing these quest helpers like this. It totally keeps me away from the story. I remember when I leveled in this game, I don't remember any quests because I just accepted them and did them.
No, I agree. At least,
previously
you'd have to. Yeah, previously you'd at least have to like scan the text, right, to see what was where, and that would probably then you'd probably be picking up
right.
some points about what was going on.
And that's why I remember the quests from the Barons in Vanilla WoW, and I remember the quests from South Shore and from, you know, everything, because you had to read through them and locate stuff, and sometimes
are you done
it was a pain in the ass to locate stuff, and you had to go to Tutbot to look for coordinates and stuff like that.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah, sometimes that was bad, but yeah, I generally agree that I think the game lost something, but on the other hand, I'm not sure that having we have to go to a farmhouse over here on the right, but I'm not sure that asking people to read through a lot of text is the best way to do storytelling in games anyways, so I'm not sure though.
This way?
No, OC, I have a quest over here, I don't know about you. I have to investigate something here.
I don't.
You don't have this?
Screw
where you have to?
I don't have that.
What the hell? Can I share it with you?
Maybe.
Okay, now I have investigated.
Maybe I don't have it.
I'm coming back to you, I think.
Tracked. Maybe I don't have it tracked.
Yeah, that. I mean, I've lost track of what I have tracked and haven't tracked. I'll come back to you, we'll see how we're looking after that. But what I was saying is that, yeah, I'm not sure about how you do storytelling best in an MMO, to be honest, because I don't think the text is the way to go. That's, people are just not reading it anymore.
It needs to be a healthy combination of spoken and written.
Yeah, probably,
Guild Wars 2 is a bit on the right track, where the dynamic heart is obviously already known on the map, but
Guild Wars 2, I think one of the things
say something and there's still text as well. So.
One of the things Guild Wars 2 does really well is having the scout system, where you can quite easily get a quick recap of the story of the area you're in, right?
Yes.
I actually think that's a decent idea.
Yeah, it is very...
Inventory full.
Oh,
okay, please. Is there a vendor around here, or do I have to? General goods. Thank you.
It might be.
Sell gray items.
Did you want to show up some crafting? The craft. If you have played WoW, then you know what the crafting in this game is. Like, pretty much.
Yeah, I'll be going over crafting in just a second.
The only difference is that you can have three crafting professions active at the same time. Kind of like
good to see you.
Lord of Rings-ish. Except that you can choose all three of them individually rather than a package.
Good to see you. Find your rings. Hello.
Yes, so I'll just get up, take up the last few items here that I can use and pick up the new quests. Okay, so this is just
this is just a
questing hub like any other MMO that is quest based. And to be honest, the questing I've seen in this game has not been amazing in any way. Problem as I see it is just that it they pretty much have two mechanics. They have kill and they have collect. Or like the one I had where I had to investigate or talk to people. But it's really not very engaging, and if this is the main part of the questing, then I can see it getting boring rather quickly.
It is.
On the other hand, of course, they have the rifts in here, which really adds some kind of dynamic element to it.
Which gets really cool in the end as well, when you get lots of events and, you know, you like while you're questing through those rifts, and it works out pretty well balanced that way. But I enjoyed this game immensely. I mean, the combat is solid and the graphics are insanely nice. I've never, like I said before with the quests and stuff, I've never gotten into the game, it's the immersion itself, like, you know, felt like I was a part of this world or in any way. It was that I've never had that feeling. Which is kind of what I want out of an MMO, I think.
Feel
you're
immersed.
Doing something for a reason, rather than I need to get to max level to do instances.
I'm looking for something called Ragnar, something. Kill Ragnar.
Oh yeah, that's the biggest swine.
Why am I not seeing it? Yeah, I'm not seeing it.
Gosh, man, you're so impatient.
Well, yeah, of course I am. I want the goddamn swine right here, right now, so I can kill it.
You kind of just get all the quests at the same spot, not even have to walk anywhere.
Actually, yeah, I want an MMO where you're just standing around waiting. Just having the quest come to you, right, and you're just getting level. Like that, that was just a lazy video I saw at some point. The MMO where you get levels whenever you click, right?
Yeah.
So,
and then, you know, because it's all about getting to max level, so why not just do it quick, leveling
exactly.
Part, and then you can finally start the game.
But what if there isn't a max level and you get a max level every time you click, then suddenly you have a game with endless progression?
Yes.
You see where I'm going with this?
That's a big problem. That's a big problem, though, with games like this and World of Warcraft, is where it's really focused on the end game, whereas the leveling is still a nice experience at times.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's
yeah.
really has nothing to do with the game itself in the end, because in the end you are doing something completely different in PvP or raiding, because your gear set is different, your playstyle is different, your abilities and everything. So everything you've done in leveling doesn't really help anymore. It has no impact on what you're doing in max leveling.
No, I think it's important that leveling is very much tied into the in-game experience in some way. So at least when you level, you learn how to play in-game as well. You learn something that's important.
Yeah.
We have talked a lot about Guild Wars 2 and how they've done it, right? And they've done it in a very good way for sure. What is this?
Yeah. Because you do get all your skills, you know, far before your max level. Maybe not all your utility skills, but you do get all your main abilities from your weapon. And the playstyle pretty much stays the same, because you're not bound to the Holy Trinity system with a tank and a healer, where like your quest solo, where you would do it in this game and WoW, and then suddenly you go to a 5-man and then you have to worry about a tank and a healer and all that stuff.
Yeah, definitely. Where I was going though is that in Guild Wars 2 they have the scaling system. And they have actually implemented that in Rift 2. They have the mentoring system where you can go back to old content and be scaled down to that difficulty. Or to that level.
Oh, really?
Of the content. Yeah,
that.
That was also introduced in 1.9. And that is actually...
That's very cool.
Yeah, exactly. Suddenly everything is... You can't just walk over everything all of a sudden.
If WoW would do that as well, then I think I would be a lot more interested in doing something like Lore Master.
Yeah, indeed. Indeed. It's not... Right, it's just a pain in the ass, to be honest, because you're not... It's so easy. Just going back and
yeah, over... Yeah, just walking through it.
I mean, I don't mind it that it doesn't necessarily have to be, like, face to the wall difficult, but it could just provide
some
kind of difficulty just because, yeah.
No, I mean, you're an advantage because you have more abilities, and the mobs will be a little bit easier because they're not as smart, maybe, but the health and the amount of damage that they do should still be up to par with what you are.
Yeah,
so it
exactly.
makes it difficult in that sense, like Guild Wars 2 does.
Exactly. But enough about that, I guess. Isn't there any
I want a
rift?
Rift? Where are the fucking rifts?
Yeah, I agree. What the?
Jeez.
I mean, we had a constant amount of rifts yesterday. They were just popping up all over the place. And now we got no
thing is,
nothing.
There's a tier over there, level 8 and 9. Let's go open it up.
Alright, I got it. I'm with you. Well, okay,
go
I'm,
up, man.
I'm running behind.
You don't have one.
Oh, bugger off. Yeah, you can just sit there like it, like that boss just look down on me.
That is the most retarded mount ever. It's like they had a concept of this mount and they made it, and then it's like there's something missing, and then they added another head. Yes.
Yeah, I think that's exactly what they've done. What are we missing here? Another head, of course.
This is too generic. I mean, the color scheme as well. It's like, what the fuck? It's
right.
like it's.
So one thing, actually,
yet.
While we're I'm just gathering stuff, mate. All right. So one
what
thing I might
that?
Actually be showing off while we're moving into that rift is something I just picked up. I just picked up an artifact right here, discarded poison bottle, and I can choose to use this artifact, and it will be placed into and it'll, it's like part of a bigger artifact. So I need 4 different artifacts for this. I can place it in the slot where it fits, and eventually, once it's completed, I will. I can go and talk to an NPC, and I'll get rewarded the lucky coin, which can be used to buy like the vanity items. So that's one of the
yes.
small things you can do. And as far as I can tell, these artifacts are just lying randomly around the world, right?
Yeah, that's pretty cool, actually. That's just really nice.
I'm not seeing the rift, by the way.
There's a tear on your map, more up.
Oh, all the way up there. Yeah. Okay. Okay. That's cool.
It's. This game was very complete when it came out. It did have a lot of the features that. You know, you expected from a AAA MMO. Besides from the looking for raid and cross realm thing,
mm-hmm.
or the looking for group thing, because they implemented that later. Which you know, in the beginning I was against looking for group, but looking for group works well. I think they need to keep it on the same server and not go across, because that's where you get the whole antisocial behavior, because people don't give a shit.
Yeah,
they don't want to see
it
again. Anyway,
it is, but that's the entire discussion about, you know, server communities and stuff, where I think we both made the case that there needs to be some kind of community on the server, because it is really, really difficult to have a cross-server community.
Right. And I mean, if you see how well Trion Worlds has actually updated this game. I mean, they had 9 updates in 1 year.
Yeah, the game is like 16 months old, yeah.
If you compare that to like vanilla WoW and 1 year amount of patches, that's probably a lot less.
They had
like
I think they had like 12 in they had like 12
3
in
years.
Vanilla, right? And vanilla was
yeah.
Was that was 2 years, right?
Three
Perhaps
years.
A bit more for Are you sure? It was
yeah.
released in 2005 here,
it's
right? Weird. And shit, Burning Crusade was from 2008, right?
Yeah.
I think you're actually right then. Yeah. Oh dear, I'm feeling so old.
I'm totally open this. Oh my god, it's.
Yeah. What? You just. Oh damn you and your that turtle.
It's a fire rift.
That's cool and all, but I'm like far away. I can see it's a fire rift, right? But
I'll wait here. It's not like that. Oh yeah, so what the cool thing is that I never mentioned to you is that if you don't do anything about the rifts, you will get overrun. the creatures will start walking away from their rift and start taking like vantage points on the map that you can be taking control of. So quests will disappear from an area until you get those points back again. It's kind of like a point capture.
And that, is that the case for every rift or just some specific kind of rifts?
Yes, every rift.
That sounds awesome, actually.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. But yeah, why did this game not get more subscribers from the start? I mean, it has like over 1 million, I think, or close to 1 million.
It had at one point at least. It's hard to tell, but they decreased the... Whoa, what is this? Do we have to stay out of that? Holy... Oh my god, that looks awesome!
Yep. Yeah, I think this game is one of the most underrated MMORPGs on the market right now.
I think the problem with this game was that it tried to do too much what WoW did, and to be honest, that's a difficult path to go, because you can't make people... Why should people sacrifice everything they've been doing in one character just to go and play another game, right? That's pretty much exactly the same. In many ways, it isn't the same, I know, but the way it presents itself, the entire, most of the leveling experience doesn't feel that different.
No, the first impression can be really bad, actually. And not to mention that WoW players are just arrogant cocks and they're not open to any kind of new suggestion, so...
But it's a whole different discussion right there. I think that's... Well, to be honest, I'm not finding this game that amazing while playing it right now. Admittedly, the rifts are kind of good fun, but I don't necessarily like the rest of it, because except for the rifts, the game feels a lot like World of Warcraft, just not as good.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like the UI just as much. I don't like the style necessarily, and I think the questing is a lot better than WoW. So admittedly, it got some features, but I'm not sure it got enough that would convince me to go over here. At least not before the end game, and the end game is just not. You know, it's hard to sell people on end game entirely because you have to level a whole ton to get there.
Yeah, that's true.
But that's just my... Actually, we're kind of getting out to the...
I think the WoW players that miss vanilla WoW kind of rating, that they will enjoy this game a lot more than current WoW.
That's probably true. As far as I can tell, the game is actually a lot harder than... than many other games, at least.
Oh, dude, those dudes are like creepy.
They're pretty big and...
Some of the design is pretty cool.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
One thing I've always had a problem with other MMOs is often the map design. Some of this has really put me down because I'm so used to World of Warcraft design. See, those mobs are running off right there. Do you see that?
What mob? What? Oh yeah, okay.
Those mobs are running off.
Let's just kill this guy, right?
You see him on the map. You see that?
Yeah, I see him. But Osu, we got to kill this guy. We're in the bonus stage.
It's all good. Relax.
Bonus stage.
Bonus stage is not very bonus at this point, because you always make that.
Okay, rift sealed. Alright, and then when the rift is sealed, you'll see out here, actually I didn't explain this menu or this UI at all, but on the top it will show what stage you're in, below it will show what you have to do, and then when it's done you'll get this icon you can click, and we'll get some good stuff for having
a And you
computer.
Press a map, and then right below us you see a fire invasion, and if you hover over it you see the arrow where they're going to.
They are.
It's kind of lame that you know that they're going to, but you know.
A bit, yeah. I guess we can just kill them, can't we? I mean,
but what happens if there's a huge invasion in the whole zone is that you see loads of those everywhere, and it's kind of cool because you basically get forced to stop questing because you can't. There's a zone invasion, and everyone will have to help. You know, get rid of those fuckers. And when it's a zone invasion, they're also elite, so you cannot solo them at times either, so you have to work together, which is pretty cool.
That sounds pretty cool to have these big battles, at least if people participate in them. I mean, what if people doesn't participate? Is the zone then just lost forever?
Yeah, until you fight back, I guess. But that doesn't happen, at least not from what I've seen in launch. People were farming rifts all the time, because you kind of need the things you get from rifts.
Yeah, I know, but launch is just a lot different from long-term play.
What?
If you know what
sure.
I mean. Alright, I was thinking of going back to the city over here just to show off the crafting real quick.
You do that, man.
I think that's about it,
though, from what we can show.
I'm suddenly finding artifacts all over the place here. No idea if that's...
You're so artificial.
You're just all over the place with those puns today.
Oh, yes.
Literally on fire.
I need to get rid of them.
What?
Yes. I just did a fire rift, so that makes sense, right?
Caught fire. Oh god, we are...
Looking for something?
Pretty bad. Oh, I actually got one platinum now, or whatever it's called. Right, let's see if I can actually, if I'm able to workbench, laboratory. Am I not able to work on my on my blacksmithing here?
Shh. I don't know.
Okay.
When I get used to like the Guild Wars features of the teleporting, I get annoyed when I click the map and I cannot just teleport somewhere. I need to walk there. God.
Question is, of course, that's a good or a bad thing. Having to just teleport all over the world kind of drops immersion a little bit, I guess. But on the other hand, it's very convenient. I'm just moving you to.
But that what is immersion? I mean, I remember in World of Warcraft, it's like walking from the North American to South American does not help the immersion at all. That is just fucking boring.
The thing is, if you suddenly, I mean, like in Skyrim as well, when you can just teleport to every place, it's, I mean, you get more action, of course, because it's more common, you know, there'll be less waiting. But on the other hand, I'm not sure if I'm a huge fan of just allowing people to skip everything, because sometimes the journey can lead to different stuff, right?
Skyrim is a single player. I think it's kind of a different rule set that you need to have there. I think that they should force people to walk more in that game. But in an MMO, I don't know. I don't have a huge problem with it. Especially not since like in Guild Wars 2, where if there's like an invasion going on that you cannot teleport somewhere. And
yeah, that's true.
In order to do stuff, you still need to walk around, because it's not like there's teleporters everywhere. It's just in the vicinity of certain areas, so it works pretty well that way.
Yeah, that's true. But I'm not 100% certain about if it's a good or bad thing, right?
No, it's convenient, that's for sure. But
yeah, that's true. That I get it's something we'll have to see over the long run how it turns out, I guess, because maybe
I mean,
it's
you
a really
do
good
need
thing.
To go and collect them, so it's not like you miss out on content in any way.
No, that's true. Alright, so just hang on a second, Yoros. I'll just be showing off the crafting, right? So, I got... Let's find it in here. Skills, right.
Yeah,
I got three professions here. I got armor smithing, I got mining, and I got fishing. Fishing in this game is as boring as it is in other games I could mention, but enough of that.
What? It's not boring at all. It's very immersive. Relax.
Just look at the circle until it splashes, then click it. If you don't catch anything, click it again next time it splashes. Yeah. Right, I'll just be crafting some tin bars here.
That's totally different than in WoW, what are you talking about?
Alright, so tin bars is...
Alright,
now I actually miss the Guild Wars system where it speeds up. Because right now...
Yes, I know, right?
Yeah.
That's such a brilliant thing as well.
This is one of the areas where they could really improve in crafting in general, but... I don't have a good crafting system like on top of my head, but I really, really don't like crafting in most MMOs. It is not engaging.
Do you think that other games are gonna adapt from that? I kind of think that they have to at some point. Like
adapt
WoW in this
from
game.
The way you mean the way crafting speeds up?
Yes.
Yeah.
You
definitely.
Think that,
I think
they might have to.
I think more game will adapt, but my point is more that I don't. That's a minor thing. I don't think crafting systems as a whole is very interesting. Or engaging, or anything.
No.
I mean, I'm really not having any kind of fun with it. I'm doing it mostly because it might provide some upgrades, or when you reach endgame, it might have some kind of importance. Like, in WoW, there's some really important stats you don't want to miss out on.
Well, and just the fact that you see these logs and mines everywhere that you just want to get along the way and maybe do something with them. So
I am almost certain I had a quest with this guy. Let's see. Craftin' Sabatoons, or however the hell you pronounce that. Alright, so I can craft...
Sabatons, man. Sabatons is French.
For real?
Sabatons. I have no idea.
Right. Nice.
Ooh, trebuchet. Can I click it? Oh, wait. This isn't my Guild Wars.
Alright, so, but yeah, as you'll see, it's just, it's so easy, right? You get a chain and plate here, you got various stuff below, you can see if it actually yields any level, or if it's gray like it is in mining right here. You can see the ingredients out here, you can mouse over it to see the stats. Now I just completed, so I get a quest, get a slight bonus to, I think wisdom is what I want. Right, I like to train for, then I can train new stuff. We'll see what's unavailable to me. That's level 10, so I'll just keep crafting these until I reach level 10, and then I can probably learn something new. Oh, what did you just do? Oh man, you are pumped.
It is a buff, I don't know what I'll do it. Fury of the Ascendant, 1 minute cooldown, requires one planet charge. Right, you gain planet charges from completing rifts. On the top left of your portrait, or the bottom left of your portrait,
yeah,
you see a planet charges, and it basically...
Three of three.
You have abilities that require planet charges, so... And this is one of the abilities. It says, against planet charges, increases target damage by 200% and reduces damage taken by 75%.
So where do I see these abilities again?
P.
Yeah.
And Ascendant Powers.
Oh, I see. Summons a Defiant Force to attack target Planar Idol. Against Planar Invasions, increase attack damage by 200% and reduce damage taken by... Not bad. Lawyers use the tear to... Ah, that's one of the things where you have like these rifts in the world that you can tear open to actually kickstart an event.
I can assist in your
training. Alright, I can buy some... Why, this crafting system, I can't even be bothered. Seriously, it's the same shit we have seen a ton of times. It's...
I am doing this.
It's not particularly interesting. I can get some... I can use this ability called Salvage Armor to... Funnily enough, Salvage Armor to get some stuff that I can use to craft again. Which is, of course, somewhat nice, I'd say.
I kind of like that ability that... You can salvage items like that.
Yeah, exactly.
Wow, should have that for their armor smithing.
That's not bad. It means you get some extra stuff if you choose to use your, if you choose not to sell your items. I think that's pretty cool, though. But overall,
yeah,
the crafting system is as boring as it's ever been made. I'm not a huge fan of those crafting systems at all. Sorry.
I'm doing a chicken, man.
Yeah, sorry. I chose to ignore you. Is that not okay?
Did you notice that? When you walk, if you have someone selected and you walk past it, your head moves towards
Yeah. I've actually seen, that seems
this
to be the
case.
This
is the first game that did that.
No, well, no, okay, World of Warcraft doesn't do that exactly. They just, whenever you're standing still and if you are, you're right-clicking, their head will move before the character does. But yeah, you don't actually follow anybody with your head. That's true. It's a nice little feature, actually. I think it's pretty cool because it makes sense that you're looking at whatever you have targeted. Also,
right.
You have the targeted persons appearing on your minimap, which is... I also think this is one of the first games to do that, but I may be wrong on that account.
Yep. So
right.
This is Rift, man.
Yeah, this is Rift. I am not sure what else there is to... I've been looking a bit at this, right? We have the character... the character UI. We have the stat UI, of course. Skills, as I was just showing up, we have the currencies. We have the currencies where we have the stuff right here, like Corrupted Soulstone and Planarite, which is what you're getting from completing Rift, and you're using that at Vendors. Actually, I've just left the Vendor in there, which is kind of stupid. But yeah, you're getting that, and you can use that for buying items. That's like part of the progression. And I guess the same goes for Favor, which is like your PvP currency. Then we have the Lucky Coin, as I said before, that's used for vanity items. Notoriety.
Go on. Sorry.
Just okay, notoriety. Your reputation bars, pretty much with different factions around the world. I'm guessing you'll be able to buy something actually when you like reach a better standing with them. We got the artifacts that I talked about before. You can see what I'm currently crafting here, and this is what I have crafted already. This one. books is what you can find around the world and add them to this collection. So you pick them up and you add them to the collection, and they don't actually fill in your inventory, and you are free to read at will. I guess I find that to be an okay feature, though would probably work better if they have a voice or something, because it's quite a lot of text. But I mean, maybe that would be kind of cool. Maybe if there was some kind of way to progress in the game by getting lore questions or whatever, right? So you'd actually get something from understanding what you were doing in the game. That might be kind of cool. You got the wardrobe, which,
yeah.
As far as I know, the wardrobe, that's like, I'm actually uncertain what the wardrobe is. Is that entire armor set, or is that just making your appearance different?
It's just your appearance, I think. Yeah.
Okay.
Now,
are you sure? Because it actually looks a lot like.
No. It's just changing your gear, yeah, I think.
Okay, fair enough then. And then we have the titles. Craft, Novice, Armorsmith, yeah, whatever. I can make cheese, Novice, Miner, great. And there's also a prefix, actually. Okay, did you have any good prefixes? Do you know any good prefixes?
No, on this gear. I have a suffix. Ironclad.
Yeah, exactly. I have Novice, Miner, which is
yeah,
like
I think that you get at level 50, there's one you can get. It's called Sir or Dame, depending on male or female.
Ozzy, please get over here. Click this guy and then look at this random adventure. Could you try and join that?
Ah.
Whatever that is.
I'm joining, but you can't join us.
The adventure?
Teleport,
I guess?
Never seen this. But I don't know if you showed this people. You can change the whole UI on the like Lord of the Rings, which is kind of nice.
Oh yeah, I should show that off in a second. We have to do stuff here. We only have so much time. Use the incinerator torches to burn spider eggs, at Freeman Run. Is that like the green circles out here or?
Yes.
Are you?
So is this like scenarios?
I am totally at a loss. Are we in an instance zone or are we outside?
Yeah, we are in instance, that's pretty sure. There's people with us though as well.
Yeah, there is. Okay, let's do some stuff. We have to like burn stuff apparently. Okay, there's somebody in doing that already.
I'm sorry, is World of Warcraft stealing this from Rift?
I'm not sure that's in
I thought it was pretty unique, the scenario system.
Plant the LB's seedling at Leighton Farmstead. Okay, so we have
water.
To move on. Jesus, why am I even getting encumbered with this stuff? Where do we have to go? Okay, down there. I'm moving.
You are so chaotic sometimes.
Why haven't we encountered this anywhere?
Why is it not like an NPC saying, hey, you might want to try this?
Yes, exactly. Okay, I just leveled up, cool. Not sure if I just get any XP from this, but... I have... But that seems decent enough, this, I guess, if only I knew what was going on. I mean, apparently it's not very good at, like, keeping people together, but...
You say potato.
And
okay,
I
so what do we do?
Hello, or...
I think we water this somehow?
Harvest it when it's... plants, water it and protect it from hungry pests. How do we water it again?
You just first plant it and then you water it with the button that popped up above your action bar.
Oh, I see. Yeah, okay, this is somewhat odd. No, little rabbit, you're not going to eat these potatoes. Watch out for any kind of vermin.
Reminds me of a quest I used that's in this game as well.
Well, this was actually the thing where you get an entire new kill. Why do everybody have mounts? God damn it.
Because everyone has alts and. Oh, I already have one platinum. You can probably buy it. No, never mind.
Yeah, that's,
can trade
that
you with a free trial account.
Oh, yeah, right. Freeman Run. That's so far away. Are you kidding me? I'm gonna be behind in every.
Teleporter close by.
This is stupid.
Yes,
just a little bit, perhaps. Yeah, well, as long as I get the XP, I guess.
Ooh, there he is, or she. Jesus, that's one ugly spider. Evidently, the bastards, or the monster design is pretty damn cool in this game.
I'm almost there. I can see you guys. Yep, you're hitting something that I can't see yet, but you're definitely hitting something. Now I can target it. Hey, holy shit! That's a pretty big spider.
Yep. Keep guessing it.
Yeah, same. Let's see. We got one guy going down. Shit.
Come on, heals. God,
if only
when
I
this
damn
combat
well
to like, Guild Wars 2, this is just so boring. Oh my god.
Actually, a lot of combat seems to be rather like, boring after you've tried that game, mostly because of the constant movement that was involved in that was really, really cool.
Yes. Not just that you... that it's fun to move, but it's you need to move.
Yeah, exactly. Oh shit, we have small spiderlings here. I think that's what might be killing us.
I shall cleave.
Can you get them open? Because I'm almost dying here.
Crying.
Yeah, they did.
There, set up.
Alright, I can heal a little bit again. Good. Right,
not to
totally
mention that in Guild Wars 2, most of your like knockbacks works on bosses and stuff like that.
That may be a good and a bad thing though. I mean, I can see it being abused to cheese something.
It's necessary because you're...
Yeah, then it's a good thing. If it's necessary, then it's good. If it's... Well, it depends, of course, if everybody have it available, but I'm pretty sure everybody
has. You don't
have a tank
and stuff, right? So it's a lot more about like hiding and doing that kind of stuff.
I saw the guys at Gamebreaker, actually. They managed to complete a run just of 5 DPSs. They said it was very difficult because nobody was spec'd into any kind of healing, but they also said that it actually was doable. So I guess that's a very good thing.
I need to heal.
I can't, man. I'm all out of healing.
Why does that mob have so much HP and doesn't do anything special?
It may be doing anything special that we're not getting.
Oh my god, I need to soul walk.
Oh, we got
wait,
a big spider.
Like a...
Uh-oh, I got aggro. Damn it.
Did you just die?
Yeah, I did.
Immediately?
Well, this is the first time I died, Lisa. How can I... Where do I have to soul walk to?
Soul walk is just like a free... an ank.
Oh,
you get
I
it every
see.
Once an hour.
Hey, we totally won.
Pick.
Okay, I don't know, except for the boss being somewhat odd, I think that was... Whoa, corrupted Sawstone,
cool.
Cool,
yeah.
We got a new adventure awaiting
cool.
right away?
Oh yeah, I just teleported back though. But you can just stay and do it again or something?
I don't know.
A different one. This is... What the fuck?
Well, I guess this is somewhat cool, I guess. Don't know if you'll get tired of it at some point, but this is rather nice, actually. And
why don't they add that to the world itself?
Good question, because this is pretty much just dynamic event, just instant. I guess they didn't have the tech to keep it balanced, you know?
No, maybe not. Because rifts are still spawning in this as well, it seems.
Well, are we sure it's actually instanced? Are we not just getting together with a group, teleported to the place, and then something's going on? And then getting an objective that nobody else can see?
But that could be very well.
I mean, that would make sense
to
me,
cool.
because it didn't seem like we are... necessarily getting teleported.
It doesn't say like leave now or something like that.
No.
No. No, my quests are still here as well, like complete them.
Yeah, exactly. So I think we
are actually rad, then.
In the same world, just teamed
you
up with all players.
Maybe like this is just phased out for other people.
That's true. It could be. If provided they have phasing available in this game.
I don't know.
Quest completed. Okay, repair and rearm wolf traps. Right.
Doing it.
Okay, I guess this should be the last thing we do, by the way.
Yep.
I think.
Okay, this is bugged because I could just keep on continue clicking the same one.
Excellent.
And we're done. Now we're not. Now we're done.
Okay, destroy something else. The only thing is, there doesn't seem to be much story going on here. We're just basically doing random stuff.
It would be nice with an NPC walking with us, with charging us to battle. Or
yeah,
something.
I mean, at least Blizzard have done that in their own version. But then again, I guess that is just this, just improved somewhat.
I suppose.
Maybe
improved. Just
I haven't actually.
Maybe
I haven't tried them
stuff
yet.
Be like that.
I'll try them out later because I just got to level 90 today from the PTR. Oh, like yesterday, perhaps.
Rats.
Well, thank you. And believe it or not, I actually had a pretty decent time getting there.
I don't believe you.
No, I thought you wouldn't.
Nah, it's just you really enjoy that style of questing. I do not really. So.
I think, nah, it's not very engaging, but that's kind of what I like about it. I don't necessarily have... I mean, I'm not playing that game to be hugely engaged in the world. Like if I'm playing DayZ or Battlefield 3 or something like that, then I'm actually playing to like be engaged and be very, very aware of everything. I'm not playing WoW like that.
Right.
The
reason I would play WoW is I just know that if I start playing it just as quest that I'll get it to raiding at some point, and I don't want to do that.
That is, of course,
sucks all the energy out of you.
Wait, why am I? I'm separated from you guys by some pretty mean guys, and. Oh, we have to go out and clean a rift. Then never mind that. I'll leave this place.
Leave what place?
Leave this place and go down to the rift where we have to be now. Because those skeletons are kicking my ass anyways.
Damage meters, man. I remember before this game supported add-ons. Before this game supported add-ons, we had like DPS parsers running in the background as like a third-party software on your PC.
You had like what?
It was like it read your combat log because your combat log gets written into this text file.
Oh dear, yeah, okay.
And it just reads the text file and showed the DPS like that. It's pretty cool. Old school, man. Old
school. All right, what are we going
to
do?
Snap us. Also refreshing about Guild Wars 2 that nobody will have that option to be like, oh my god, your DPS low, because it's all about survival rather than...
Somebody will probably be doing it anyways, but yeah, I agree.
Yeah.
It will be interesting to see if they
do require you to do a certain amount of DPS.
It'll be a lot harder to evaluate people's individual, how they're doing, their performance.
Then again, it's only like 5-man instances, pretty much, so... I mean, you do have the dynamic events that will go up to 10 people and stuff like that, so I don't know. The end game, and again, that's this whole discussion that nobody really knows.
Yeah. But I mean, that's what kind of scares me, that I think they've been very silent about what they actually imagine end game and progression will be. Okay, we just keep rolling. Holy,
whoa.
Holy, geez. Wow, that was underwhelming.
Oh, he died. Yes.
I hate when that happens. Just suddenly seeing this huge boss and everybody's just going, oh my god, that's so huge. And then he just falls over.
But evidently.
Oh, we got more.
That is pretty damn awesome, those events.
Yeah, if they just have to be scaled.
I really like this.
I guess. Well, we
But
got
can you
him.
just level this way and just ignore
I
quests?
think you
That would be
can, yeah,
cool.
that's kind of what I'm thinking. Though I'm not leveling
No.
very fast, but then again, I wasn't before either, so.
Bit more engaging. Let's
At
get
least
down
you
to
have to,
this.
at least you have to pay, you know, pay attention a bit. What were I just saying?
Should we end this video soon? It is dragging on a
Yeah, it
bit.
is. I was just thinking if we are not done with this soon. Like, really soon.
Yes.
And then I'm thinking, I'm
maybe
not joining another one after this, for sure. Because,
Oh,
yeah,
dude,
it is kind of dragging on.
It's a dude.
I'm just kind of wondering
Dude
if there's
here.
anything we have forgotten to show. I don't think so.
I don't
as
think
the game
so.
got this, they got the dungeons, they got the rifts. They have the PvP as we talked about, the PvP we have shown, they have the conquest mode which was newly introduced. They have this very interesting mentoring system, they have the not so interesting crafting system. Oh dear, I'm getting myself killed here, I think. Oh, somebody helped me. Excellent.
Hey, that's kinda cool. When mobs are really big, the health bar is like on the bottom rather than
Yeah,
on
so
the
it's
top.
It's always in your view, that's very good. Oh, those thing, those tentacles looks pretty damn cool. Whoa, he just died. I just thought I healed him a bit. So you probably have to like keep attention with stuff on the ground here. Well, I think I saw the ground turn red just a moment ago.
Yeah, red circles.
Right there, yeah. Red circles, that's just the usual stuff. Getting kind of popular, that whole stuff with just marking the ground and moving out. I think they have to come up with a new mechanic soon though, because it's getting kind of old.
Yeah.
No, don't. Yeah, this is really.
So sick of this. I'm so sick of these rotations that you have to do.
Most games will have those in some matter. I mean, you can hardly have something where I don't have any kind of rotation, can you? Okay, another cut.
I'm sure. I guess. But...
I mean, I don't know. Maybe you can. Ignore. Right. But I'm leaving the group. Alright, the last thing I just wanted to show off real quickly, I think we already showed this last episode actually, but this is this whole soul tree, which is just a talent tree,
Look,
the way it works.
I'm sorry, when you left the group, it says on the top here, join adventure again. Just like, I wonder if that's just if there's something close by, you can just like the public group thing that it pops up, like join adventure, that would be pretty cool.
I don't actually see what you're talking about.
No, it's gone now because they moved on.
Oh, okay,
down.
I wasn't paying attention
guy.
Then. Anyways, as I was just saying,
yeah.
So I have selected a pre-selected build, if you will, which means that you know the game will indicate which talents I have to pick. It's very very simple, but to be honest, otherwise this would seem really for a new player like me. This is intimidating. These three trees. So to be honest, I kind of like the system where you're saying what role you'll be in the game will just help you. And then when you get better at the game, you'll probably try and make your own tree and make your own adjustments that suit you very well. So that's kind of cool. Down here we have the spells that will become available as you use talents up in the top part of the tree. So I'll try and use another one here. Yeah, you'll see that unlocked this called Censure, which deals some more damage. Okay, and now there are indicators I have to put talents over here. And that's pretty much just how it works. I think I'm out of extra or talents or soul or whatever you'll call it. Yeah. I'm out of points now. So that's just how it works, and you unlock new skills, and that's all cool. The only problem, as I see it, is that there's a lot of overlap between the abilities in the various trees. So that means that you may have several abilities that actually does the same, but you'll only be using one of them because they belong to the tree which you specced into, and which have then made that ability kind of stronger. And to be honest, that's just an unnecessarily confusing system. If you have two abilities that does the same, then by all means just make them the same ability. There's no reason to have the other system, in my opinion.
Ooh, I just got an interrupt and a fear, massive fear.
I mean, it just deals weapon damage, deals something to plus weapon damage, must be reused after the cleric has been dashed apart, alright? And this one is deal 50% weapon damage. I mean, I'm getting so many damage abilities the various count right now, it's very much overwhelming. Yeah, that's about it. So I guess we'll there'll be a little more in-depth view of what to do in Rift, and you know, we've tried to give you a bit of an impression of that. So we'll have a third video from Rift about our last impression of it, our last what's that called? Those
final words.
Final words, if you will. Yeah, or judgment on the whole thing. And we'll link you to it, of course, so you can go and see that right after you've seen this. So, thank you very much for watching this video, everyone, and we'll see you later.
See ya.